Hey everyone, it's Hailey, and today I'm basically going to be making fun of myself. So I have an issue that kind of started like last fall, and it has gotten out of control and I have never been able to get it under control again. So while you guys might not notice, I kind of feel like my reading has slowed down a little bit from previous years. It isn't drastic, like I'm still obviously reading a ton. However, I used to read like so much, and I used to read books super, super quickly. If a book was taking me longer than 3 days to finish, I would be like, no, this is taking me way too long to read, and I would just like rush myself through it. So obviously that's awful, so I stopped doing that, which is yay, woo, goo, you go girl. So luckily I stopped doing that, and the reason that I did that is because there's so much pressure with doing this whole channel to like keep up with new releases and keep up with sequels, but at the same time read a bunch of older popular YA and just popular books in general. Like, there's a lot of pressure to read. So when I have books coming in from publishers and I have books that I'm interested in and I'm trying to like balance it all, I would really have to read quickly so that I could keep up with it all. Eventually I was just kind of like, whatever, I'm not doing this anymore. I'm gonna read at my own pace and not stress if a like 500 page book is taking me longer than 3 days to read. So that's kind of been my like easygoing attitude for the past year, I think. I don't know. All of a sudden I was just like, meh, who cares if it's taking me longer than 3 days? So while this has been liberating, it also has been incredibly stressful because I now have a mountain of sequels that I haven't read yet that have come out forever ago. You guys know I'm super picky with the sequels that I choose to read, and the reason for that is the reason why I have so many piled on my TBR. I'm gesturing here because they're on my bed. You can't see it, but I promise they are here. If I don't really enjoy a book, I'm not gonna pick up the sequel. If I don't love it and I'm not invested in those characters, then why have it sit on my TBR when I have so many other books that I want to read, so many other sequels that I want to read that I am really invested in that universe and in those characters, and so many universes and characters that I want to be introduced to for the first time. It's so hard to keep up with the sequels when there's constantly amazing books coming out that are just like the first in a series or a standalone, and I really want to read those. And I find myself more often than not, I will reach for a completely new story rather than a sequel. I think a lot of why I do that is because of something that I've kind of mentioned recently, and that's the fact that once I close a book, I'm done with it. There are certain stories where I would love to read a continuation, and I would love for the authors to continue it, but at the same time, I understand why an author ended a story where they did, and I don't think that they should give into the pressure of continuing a story just for the sake of continuing it. Cursed Child is a prime example of that being an awful, awful idea. I hate that book with a passion. So I'm content with like where characters end up and their story being done where the author chose to end it. And sometimes that means I only want to read the first book, but then at the same time, sometimes I do really want to read the sequel. So since the information about those books leaves my mind the second it comes out, and then you have to wait a year, usually like 9 times out of 10, for the sequel to come out, in order to like read the sequel, I feel like I need to reread the other book, but I don't like rereading books because I have so many new books that I want to read. Do you see the struggle and the stress of this? Anyways, I've been talking for so long, so let's just shut me up and get into the video. These are in no particular order, but first we have The Enchantress Returns by Chris Colfer. This is the second book of Land of Stories, and I've had this since about December, and I want to listen to the audiobook, but for whatever reason, it just hasn't really been at the top of my TBR. I do really want to read it, but I don't know why I haven't picked it up yet. Who knows? Next is Put In by Julie Murphy. I've had an arc of this for so long, and I haven't read it, and I hate when I have an arc of a sequel and I haven't read it yet, because that's like so much worse, especially because now this book is out. So this isn't like technically a sequel, it's a companion to Dumplin' by Julie Murphy, but for all intents and purposes it is a sequel, and it's one that I haven't read yet and I really want to, and I feel like would be super quick, but like I suck. Next is Fireblood by Ellie Blake. This came out I don't even know when. I want to say like last October or something. It's the sequel to Frostblood by Ellie Blake. I did enjoy Frostblood, and I'm interested to see where the story is going to go, but I also remember zero about the book. But I really want to read this one because the author's local, and I would love to support a local author who has been picked up by a big publisher. Like, that's amazing. So I do really want to read it, but like, hey, here we are. Why did I start singing? I don't know. Next is The Beauty of Darkness by Mary E. Pearson. This brick has been on my TBR for like over a year now, almost 2 years. I'm willing to bet it might be even more than 2 years. Part of why I haven't read this yet is because, one, I don't remember what happened in the second book. Super on brand. I feel like I sounded really Canadian when I said brand just then. Anyways, I think I'm also just intimidated by its size. Insert dirty, inappropriate joke here, but hopefully eventually I will buck up the courage to finally open this damn thing. Next is One Dark Throne by Kendara Blake. The next book in this series is coming out, I think, in September. It is coming out in September, and here we are. I've had it since it came out and haven't read it yet. Why do I do these things to myself? Same idea is The Defiant by Leslie Livingston. I don't know when this one came out, actually, but it is the sequel to Valiant. This, by the way, is part of, did I even say what series these books are a part of? This is the second book to Three Dark Crowns, and then this one is the third book to The Kiss of Deception, or The Remnant Chronicles, whatever you want to call it. But like I said, this is the sequel to The Defiant. I think I finished that sentence. I don't honestly remember. See why I don't remember things in books? I can't remember what I said 2 seconds ago. But I loved The Valiant so much, like so many of these books. I loved the first book so much, and I'm like, yay, can't wait for the sequel. And then I get the sequel and I'm like, okay, now sit on my shelf and like marinate for like 6 years. Marinate? What? I don't know what's happening. Why am I talking about books like they're meat? Next is Map of Fates by Maggie Hall. This is the sequel to The Conspiracy of Us, and The Conspiracy of Us is a book that really surprised me with how much I enjoyed it, and I really liked the story, and then I was like, yeah, I want to continue it, and then I just never did. Next are two books by the same author, which once again have been here for so long. Literally, I just feel like they might be stuck to the shelves in my room because they've been here for so long. Literally, they're probably starting to like fossilize on my shelves, but those books are The Darkest Magic and Rebel Spring by Morgan Rhodes. Rebel Spring has been here for so long. I've had this book probably since the first year I was doing BookTube. And this one hasn't been on my TBR for quite as long, actually, because I just read the first book, A Book of Spirits and Thieves, recently. And by recently, I mean like months ago, maybe even a year ago. But I did really, really like it. And I think why I haven't read the sequel to this one is because I can't find the audiobook. I listened to the first one on audio and I really liked it, but then I think they stopped making the audiobooks for some reason. I don't know. Let me know if you found it or something. I don't know. And Rebel Spring, I need to reread Falling Kingdoms before I dive into this one, and that's so much work. So I just haven't done it yet. Next is The Crown's Fate by Evelyn Skye. This is the sequel to The Crown's Game, which once again was a really pleasant surprise to me. And I wasn't actually sure if I wanted to read the sequel at first, but then I just decided to go for it. And by go for it, I mean purchase it and then let it sit on my shelf. And the final sequel that I have yet to read is The Reluctant Queen by Sarah Beth Durst. This is the sequel to Queens of Blood, and it came out around Christmas last year. Now, like I said, usually in between books in a series, there is about a year, give or take. However, imagine my surprise when I open my door and find this package on my doorstep. This is the next book in this series. It is book 3. This is book 2. This is when I know it's a major problem and I need to get to it, is when I haven't even read book 2 yet and book 3 is out and on my doorstep. Don't get me wrong, I'm so excited to read both of these. Why do I do these things to myself? Why? So hopefully, eventually, I will be able to get to these, but like, oh my god. Maybe by the time you guys see this video, I'll have gotten to some of these on this list, but like, really doubtful. So those are all of the sequels that I have yet to read. This was a really eye-opening video to film, and now I just feel stressed out by the amount of sequels that I have to read and the amount of new releases that I haven't read yet. Oh, there's also the one by Libba Bray. I don't even know where it is. It's not even on my shelf right now. Where did it go? But Before the Devil Breaks You by Libba Bray, which is the third book of The Diviners. I need to read that, but I think I need to reread Layer of Dreams, and both of those are so big, and I'm just... Oh god, I'm dying. If I had a white flag, I would be waving it now. But please let me know how many sequels you have on your TBR. Maybe it'll make me feel better. Maybe it'll make me feel worse. I don't really know, but let me know anyways. Also, let me know if you have read any of these sequels, which ones I should prioritize, and hopefully I'll get to them. Oh god. But thank you guys so much for watching today's video. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe and click that little bell icon so you'll be notified whenever I post. I put up new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, so there's constantly new content. That sounded so infomercial-like, I am so sorry. But you can also follow me on all of my social media. All of my handles will be down below. I would love to chat with you guys about books there. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!